Have you ever been to one?
I've been to a wedding reception in Scotland, and they're sort of like a big ceilidh.
Oh.
No. Here for Gabby. Thank you.
Bernie Mac.
Oh, look at that.
See you then.
Good morning, Gabby. Oh, see you, Michael.
Hey.
Oh, it was a bit dark at the time.
Michael, Matthew, what's this, man?
Looks like a sock to me, though.
Yeah, just sock it to me.
Sucky, sucky, nah. Come on, baby.
What's that stuff on it? Can you see?
I wouldn't like to say it on public television.
I'm feeling quite three-dimensional today. I really should be looking for somewhere else to live. I've been living at Michael's for long enough now. He's been very kind, but it's really time to move on. I'm in love with my osteopath. Sometimes I go and see him, and there's absolutely nothing wrong with me. He reminds me of Clark Kent.
Oh, come on, Mike, you realise that.
Yeah,
yeah.
I want some pictures.
I'm the chairman of the board.
Liz, what sort of hair did you used to have when you had hair?
Well, that's a painful subject.
Actually, I think I'm getting a wig today.
Yeah.
Oh, you don't need one, you're kidding.
I want a wig,
nice,
right, no discussion.
Oh, no, you don't need one.
Anything?
Yeah, why not?
Yeah. So I'm gonna take a trip down Shepherd's Bush Market. Oh. And get a wig.
Haven't you got a wig, Ellen?
Oh yeah, by the way. Why don't you try mine? Oh, you wouldn't like it. It's not you, really. Oh, well, be careful with it though, you know? You know what I mean?
Not my shade really.
What's is it real hair, Ellen?
It's real, it's very, very expensive.
Oh, yeah, I like it, yeah.
I spent all my last check on it, really.
Ooh.
Oh, it's you.
It's a bit hippie, though.
Peace, brother.
No.
Yeah, you're right.
Anyway.
No,
I'm getting wrong. Lovely. Jane Mansfield blonde number, you know what I mean?
Mm. We know what you mean.
How long have I got?
Well, we start the spot call at 3. Be back 4:30 because we're shooting at 5.
Right. Okay, then I'll see you guys later.
Have a good time.
See you later.
Yeah,
bye.
See you later.
Bye.
Well, get me some hair gel while you're there. Ooh. That's probably Jane. Yeah, that's cool. I'm sick of having my picture taken. Maybe it's that sexy photographer again.
Which one?
I can't remember his name.
Oh, well.
You're getting a bit experimental over there, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm buying a wig today.
Those flowers, take them away. They're only funeral decoration. This is the fall and this is a drudge nation. Your decadent sins will reap discipline. You Puritan, you shun me. I wash every day, but still it's... unclean! Unclean!
Do it.
A thousand souls, you can only save your own. A sort of blood, but always good. It's like I've drunk myself sober. The better as I get older. Have on jeans and don't be gone. Second half of Spectre versus Rector. Rector lived in Hampshire. You probably know this if you've got the record. Somewhere I like breaking it in easy for you.
Chico.
Hey, brothers, wait, this long. And do we have to fall? Hero and Inspector walk from the scene. Is a hero banished forever? The Spectre. The Spectre. The Spectre. Possesses the hero, but the possession is ineffectual. The rector is half insane. But the hero goes back into the mountains. Such hatred,
I search, hey, true, 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 son. I search, hey, true, son. And your second and sins, you'll be back, disappeared. And your second and sins, you'll be disappeared. Hail the new Puritan, righteous maelstrom.
The refusal of genius to fulfil its destiny has been a problem of mankind's since 1911. Pap art nor ghoulish tinkering is not science. That old geek philosopher Alvin Stardust once said, Bob Geldof for president, that's my motto. This denial of creation gave birth to one M. Clark, a man who doesn't know where that reality is or where that hack lives, but gleans that his vestige is future, and unbeknown but half told has the quirk that makes him innovate.
How can we quantify the mongolization of the class and soccer via Frankie Goes To and Ipswich Oxford United gross imposition obscenity?
I'm the Scottish gin. I can't recompense for my glory grabbing. Read gold, no glory.
How can we quantify the destruction the Polish have wrought on us? Some wash so much their features are eroded. Stick that in the guts of your average British ad anti-eye leftist qualify merchant.
Round my reign. They all embrace the persuaders of Lavender Hill. Fireworks in hand. Like perfume pelt from rooftops gathered, the windowsills on smokeless southwest homes.
But computer trust will be the death of the American brain. Can we rise out of this? Can we shirk the Republican bug?
And them folk were deaf. But the real populace steeped in panache. Like litter, the spirits of cheap liquor and newsagent perfume. A newsagent perfume. A newsagent perfume.
Well, Mike, this is the scab you must take on. The computer hamlets, inefficient in their cock-ups, are not something to dance past.
Thank you.
Pink Press Rats! I'm riding two class on a one-class train. I'm sort of not like a windy crane on a Pink Pulse Rats! Get out the Pink Press Rat file and umbrts about the subject. It's Delos, Recluse, Time. Get to the safe house, hanging rhyme, hang this crummy blitz trap by its neck. Pink press threats. I escaped the pink prol effect. It's new prol after it, so it's recluse, safe house time. Then the clan began.
A car at my street. A car. Good.
It was bloody awful.
The wind's blowing in totally the wrong direction.
Come on, we'll have to do it again. Come on.
Again?
Brilliant one with a plaque, there would be.
Oh, no, you've got no taste. No, I
just wearing it. Me, I know.
No, and change positions. Yeah, I love it. Okay, into your costumes. Go on.
Thank you.
Oh, hi.
Hi.
Oh, what do I look like tonight then? Beautiful?
What do I look like tonight?
Oh, like something out of a laundrette.
I'm a bit parched. I think I'm going to get another drink. Are you all right for a drink?
Oh, yeah, I'm all right. I'm just a bit bored.
Trojan? Trojan?
Troj!
Yes? Could you mix Rachel and me another drink, please? You are going to have one, aren't you, now?
What? What did you say? Excuse me, I was talking to you.
Look okay.
What do you mean okay? I'm beautiful.
How many meanings has okay got?
How many what?
Meanings has okay got?
I mean...
Rachel, listen, do yourself a favour and put something else on.
Yeah, do yourself a favour, get a facelift and go on a diet while you're at it.
Thank you, Trojan.
Oh, thanks, Troj.
That straight vodka?
Yeah.
Thanks, darling. How are you feeling?
I'm glad there's no one in it, come to think of it. I'll sit over here now.
No, you're just asking me to throw this drink all over your face. You look like a... You do.
Are you okay, Trojan?
Yeah, I'm fine.
I think you've had a bit too much to drink.
Trojan.
What time is it, Rachel?
I love you.
What time is it, Rachel?
Honestly, what is he like?
Rachel, you don't look good in black, Trojan. You don't look good in that dress. I've got an idea I'm going to change myself. Listen, it's early enough. Michael hasn't arrived yet. We've still got time to change and look H.O.T. for the nightclub.
But have you tried plastic surgery?
How bitter can one woman be?
Oh, you should know. You're right, Troj.
No.
Do you want to get out?
I wish Michael would come out. I honestly do.
He will.
Oh, maybe he's here.
Oh, your dreams come true.
Oh, Michael!
Trojan.
Hi, darling. How are you?
Oh, not too bad, a bit shanked.
You look pretty nice. Yeah. Check yourself out. You look lovely.
I'm
a
schoolmistress, don't I?
Well, I'll give you another name. Oh, are you taking
the light, darling?
Michael.
Yeah, what have you got?
Oh, sorry,
Michael.
Oh, Rachel. What do you want? What do you want, Michael?
Oh.
What have you got?
Vodka.
Oh, fine.
Take a seat. Get the weight off your sling bags. So, what have you been up to?
What a day.
Honestly, I'm so pleased you came, because Rachel, Trojan and me weren't getting on too well.
I could feel tension in the air when I came in.
The thing is, we can't decide if we should wear what we've got on. I've got a good mind to take it off right now.
It's a bit retarded, isn't it?
The thing is, you'll excuse me a minute.
I think I'm going
to skip into something a bit more suitable.
Yeah, I think you should. Try the bar.
I think it's all right,
yeah.
Hey? Ooh. Oh, that's a nice Trojan.
Yeah.
And then you.
No.
This hairdo's a bit limited. It's a new look.
Yeah, do you like it? Oh. We made these. Oh,
you like to flash it around, don't you?
Oh, well, you know. Oh, what are you doing with your hair then?
Well, it's either up or it's down.
Mm.
And I always prefer it up, really, for the night time.
I like it up as well.
Everybody knows that.
You're right, darling. What are you looking at me like that for?
Oh, Rachel, look for us tonight.
Oh. Punk's dead, Michael.
Did I hear you mention my name?
Oh, you look nice to me.
Yeah, it's my middle name, Michael. You should know by now. I'm the punk of the 80s.
Oh, you've lost so much weight, Lee.
No, it's just this garment. I'm from behind.
You might have a garment that fits me. I feel a bit underdressed.
I think you do a bit as well. Look okay.
You always do.
Well, why don't you try and slip something on from my wardrobe? Oh. There's plenty of things out there.
That does look nicely, I must say.
Oh, thank you. It's very unusual to get a compliment from you, Rachel.
Oh, Lee, that's lovely.
Still not quite sure.
What about?
Well, I don't know. Is it today?
Hmm.
Sex.
Beg your pardon.
Oh, yeah.
You ready to go out then, Michael?
Oh, I've got a date. I'm going to go home.
Are you going to come out at all?
Yeah, I'm going to go home after my date and get changed.
Bye, Michael.
Will I catch anything?
Yeah, you better go. I'll see ya. Bye. Oh, bye, Michael.
I'll see you later.
Bye, see ya.
Oh.
Don't worry, bothered coming.
I know, I'm quite looking forward to tonight.
Oh, look at this phone.
Phone never stops ringing.
Oh.
Well, sometimes it does.
Rachel, it...
Oh, darling. Well, I need something down me before I go out.
Rachel, I've got some downers here.
Oh.
Oh, I know her.
Children.
Oh. Okay. Okay, Michael. How are you?
Simone, it's like it, Simone.
She tickled the brain with all the peach.
No, what was this letter?
Dimension for at least 15 seconds.
Well, I wasn't really going to tell anyone this, but...
Having a good time.
I think he's absolutely gorgeous. Of course, there's no hope for me because he's gay, you know. Really, I'm not.
I did murder Martin Brown. So watch out, banging old faggot. You're next.
Touch but my lips with those fair lips of thine, Michael.
Intentions.
No, it wasn't that. It was some...
Well, here we are. One world where there is enough food.
Lips on lips.
Fly on the toilet seat.
It's better than a hospital.
Red.
Will.
What?
Help.
Beyond perversion.
In fact, it is a hospital. A dick to all.
Nine eyeballs.
Has anybody got a painkiller?
Tomato sauce on my chin. I hope not. If I have, it's going to ruin the whole evening.
Oh, I can't. I'll come back in a minute, all right? I'm a London fashion designer, and I started off making coats for dogs. I've now progressed to a store called Spend, Spend, Spend in Hyper Hyper, so get down there and spend your money.
Carius Smith David Van Helene.
Well, I've been an alcoholic now for 6 years, and I've lost the kids, lost the wife. My life's a mess. All I can say is don't do it. Anybody out there, any young people, it's not worth it. No way.
The only infinity, the only purity, the only love.
Hello. I'm not a freak, I'm a person.
Right, I just want to say I want to see Land of the Giants, The Singing Ringing Tree, and Lost in Space on television.
Repeat.
Yeah.
So, boys, if you want to take me cruising on an ocean liner, you can.
Thank you.
just because they're so big. 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 So big. Just because they're so big. Just because they're so big. And then you've got sensitive to the touch. Just because they're so big. And then you've got sensitive to the touch.
Thank you. Is your heart filled with pain? Shall I come back again? Tell me, dear, are you lonesome tonight?
I wonder if you're lonesome tonight. You know, someone said the world's a stage and each must play a part. Fate had me playing in love with you as my sweetheart. Act one was when we met. I loved you at first glance, and you read your lines so cleverly and never missed a cue. Then came act two. You seemed to change. You acted strange, and why, I've never known. Honey, you lied when you said you loved me, and I had no cause to doubt you. But I really go on hearing your lies, and to go on living without you. Now the stage is bare, and I'm standing there with emptiness all around. And if you won't come back to me, then they can ring the curtain down.
Is your heart filled with pain? Shall I come back again? Tell me, dear, are you lonesome too?